I'm excited today because I get to marry my best friend. I just feel very blessed to have known Kim and come this far with her and just to start our lives out together. It's really exciting.
I've been a walking heartache. I've made a mess of me. The person that I've been lately ain't who I want to be. But you stay here right beside me. Watch as the storm blows through and I need you. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. For when I think I lost my way, there are no words here left to say it's true. God gave me you.
So today I'm really looking forward to the moment when I see Chris when I walk down the aisle, and also seeing all of her family and friends who've traveled all over the country to be with us today. It'll be so fun to just have everyone that we know and love in one space for an entire day and to celebrate with them.
An angel loved it, somehow fall for me. You'll always be loved, sweetheart.
This afternoon, we gather to honor God's gift to Kim and to Chris of the love that unites them. It is through the great love God has for them that we gather here. God gave us marriage for the full expression of the love between two people. In marriage, two people belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, they freely give of themselves to one another. God's love is of the agape sort. Selfless and relentless and given graciously, even when it's not offered in return. And so while I hope that you certainly do cultivate both romance and friendship in your marriage, may you also emulate Christ's self-giving love.
I, Kim, take you, Chris.
To be my husband, my partner in life, and my one true love.
To be my husband, my partner in life, and my one true love.
I give you my hand, my heart, and my love.
From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live.
From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live.
By the vows made this day in the presence of God and this community, I declare that Kim and Chris are now joined in the covenant of marriage. You may kiss one another.
Became good friends while they were still at Grand Valley, but it took just a little more time and one sort of failed attempt to get a group of friends together for them to start building their relationship. We were trying to meet up to see a movie, but everyone ended up not being able to make it except for these two. And that is where it all began.
Chris, thank you so much for being such an amazing brother and remaining to this day one of my biggest role models on how a man should act, both creatively and spiritually. I have no doubt that you and Kim have both made the best decision of your lives, and I love both of you so, so much. Congratulations, Chris and Kim. May God bless both of you, and may you be happy all the days of your lives.
I remember the day that you're born back in Suffern, New York, March 19th, 1991. Around 1 o'clock that morning, you let Mom and I know that you were ready to enter the world. So we contacted your grandparents who were living in New York near us, and your Uncle Jimmy, and they all rushed to the hospital. And 11 short hours later, you entered the world. May your marriage and family be blessed with happiness and good health. And may the best day of your relationship so far be the worst day of your future life together. To Kim and Chris.
Despite it being, you know, a super warm day, it was really good. I think the church went really well. We had a really nice message from Dorothy, and now it's just, we're having so much fun celebrating with everybody.
Yeah. And it's been amazing just seeing everybody come in from out of town and just being with all these different people that are from so many circles in our lives and just having this one day together with them where, you know, we get to just be with them all day long and celebrate with them, which has been so amazing.
It's been really
so
special.
Fun to.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, so
I
fun.
Love you.
I love you too.